Hello everyone, so in this video I'm going to show you how we can create a login and sign up page in MIT App Inventor app with the help of Firebase. So click on the new project and my project name is Firebase Login. Here is our first screen. So in the left side we'll find the layout option and just drag it off that vertical arrangement like this and make this width and height is fill parent like this. Now we need to just use your two text box. In the left side we'll find the one text box like this and make this text box width is 70% like this. Just copy and paste, use Ctrl C or Ctrl V like this or Command C, Command V like this. And I'm gonna use your one more layout, that is the horizontal arrangement like this. And I need to make that arrangement to the width is fill parent like this. And just drag and drop one button like this and make that width is around 30% like this. Let's try it 40%. That will look more good. Yeah, 40%. And in this button, I'm going to just copy paste that button. And the first button name is just like login. Okay. And the another button is sign up. Okay. So sign up here. Now what we need to do here, I'm going to just click on the vertical arrangement and make the thing is in a center like this. Horizontal and vertical both should be signed like this. Cool. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just make that horizontal arrangement should be in a center also like this. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to make one 5% label into between these buttons. Okay, remove the text and just add the height is automatic. The width is 5% like this. Cool. So I'm going to make that background color to something is like, you can make it anything pink, like let's try. And for the horizontal, I'm going to just remove the background color of this to none. And click on the login button and you can change that login color turn and make that text color to the white and just change font size to the 18, make it font bold like this. Do the same thing for that button also like this, or you can do, you once you design your one button, you can just need to copy and paste the another button. Okay, so you don't need to, you know, again and again do the, you know, all that font size and everything, you don't need to do so like this. Cool. So we have this. Okay. Now we have two buttons here. We have this text box one and text box two. But text box one is like for the username like this. And this one is the password. But we need to use the password text instead of that text. So just drag and drop that text and make this width is 75% and delete that text box. Okay. Or you can use add as a confirm password also. Cool then. So we have that. Okay. Now I'm going to just remove the 5% to make it like, you know, 2% something track. Okay. Cool then. So this is our page. Now I need to design the another main screen of my app. So once the people log in, sign up, or they log in, they will redirect to their main screen, main page. So this is our main page, suppose. And let's make it hide and with this fill parent like this. Okay. And I'm going to use your one label like this and just say welcome TCB and just make it 25 and 4 and just copy paste this and just say here the main screen. Okay, make bold thing in a center like this. Okay, so this is our main screen. Okay, so once the people log in successfully, so they will redirect to our main screen. So I'm going to just visible off and turn visible on to this or first screen. Now I need to display one label also in the top like this. So I'm going to remove that from text here, but make sure the text color will be the red like this. And for the background color, I'm going to just change it. Let's try something different. And cool. So this is our warning message. So I'm going to just remove the text from here for now. Cool. Now this is our main screen sign up button and their login button. That's the one username. So hint is username, and hint you can just put the password like this. Okay, now what do we need to do here? I need to use the one component in the left side. You'll find the experimental and just drag and drop the Firebase. Nowadays we need to just hide this and just drag and drop Firebase here. Cool. Now let's go to the Firebase. Open the firebase.google.com and go to the console. You need to create account if you don't have the create account in the Firebase. So just create account with Google and click on the add project. see, this is the ad project, and my project name is Signup Login App Inventor. Okay, you can type any app, okay, name, and just click on continue. Configure is like a default account Firebase, click on create project. It will take around 20 seconds to create your overall project. Okay, done. So let's click on the continue and wait some seconds to load that dashboard. Good. In the left side, you will find the all products. Click on this and scroll down. You will see the real-time database. This one. Just click on this. Now we need to create account. So like real-time database, and just we need to create here. So wait some seconds. We need to create database. So you see, create database. Click on this. Now click on the next. Now click on the enable. First of all, go to the rules option and make sure that should be true. Okay, so we can read and write the data in our app. Okay, like this. Okay, like this, make it public. Yes, done, dismiss. Let's go to the data option. You can see this is the app link. Okay, so just copy that link. Okay, let's go to the MIT App Inventor and click on the Firebase DB. You can see Firebase URL. Just paste your URL here. Done. Now let's go to the blog section. So wherever someone click on the button one. Okay, this one. So this is our login button. Let's see. This is the login button. This is the button one. So once the people click on the button one, it means once the people click on the login, so we need to log in. But before login, we need to sign up, because without sign up, we can't log in. Okay. So how we can do this? So first of all, we'll do one thing is like change to the button two. So once the people click on button two, we need to sign up. So for that, what I need to do, click on the Firebase. You can see the store data. See, call it. So store value, tag and value to store. So what is the tag? Tag is the username. So suppose someone put the username Saurav or anything. So that will put in the text box one. So that is text box one dot text. And the value that we need to store. So for that, so the value that we need to store is a password. So click on the password text box and you will see the password text box dot text. Call it like, so that will store our tag. It means as my username, and that will store my password. That's simple. Now we have done the sign up process. Now how we can log in? After this, you can just say, you know, print the message like sign up done or something like that in that label. So which label? So we have the label is called level 4. So level 4, go blog, level 4 dot text. And just display here, and you can just display the text is sign up done, sign up done, something like that. Okay, but make sure you can't display that to the RAD. Okay, so for that you need to change that one thing also, set level 4 dot text color, and that will be the green. Okay, so here like this. Okay, sign up done. Now after how we can log in. Okay, so once we receive the data here, now we need to fetch the data and we need to check that user is exist or not. So let's click on the button one. Now when someone click on the button one like this, so what we need to do, we need to fetch the data first of all. So first click on the Firebase and see here the get value, this one we need to call. So first up we need to call the tag. So first we'll check text box one dot text is actually the user is exist or not. If value tag is not there, so we can say our username and password, or you can say wrong username and password like this. Okay, this is the common message. You can add any message. Now what we need to do here, I'm going to just set that text value. Make sure that value should be the red. Okay, set level. Now, after receiving the value, after fetching the value, will that Firebase will call this got value. So after getting the value, we need to use your condition if else, like control, use the if. Whatever the value we receive from that tag, so we need to match the value. Click on the logic and just drag and drop it here. And that is something, that value that we received from that tag, that should be matched to the password.text. If that will match, that will match, then we will display the, will hide, that will display that main screen visible on, turn on like this, true, just type true like this. But else if that will not display, okay, so we can just say here the set label dot text, not text color, that should be text, this text, okay, that remove that color and that value. So what value we will get? We will get that value wrong username and password, like this. It's simple, is that? It's just a very simple app. Let me just try how this will work in the design. Let's go to the design. Let's try connect and let's try to AI companion. So you can see this is our Firebase, okay? And you can see this is our app. Let's put the username, okay? So username is suppose Saurabh, and the password I'm gonna just put here the 1234 suppose. Let's click on the login, okay? You can see wrong username and password because there is nothing. Let's click on the sign up now. You can see sign up done. And you will see here the Firebase. You can see the real-time Firebase Saurabh. Now let's click on the login button. Now you can see the main screen. Oh, we need to hide that screen. As you can see, this is still display. So let's go to the MIT App Inventor. Go to the blog. And what we have done, we have just display the value. But we need to hide the vertical. Another arrangement is called the vertical arrangement. One should be false. Like this. Okay. Let's refresh this. Let's try again. Okay, not save. Let's click on the username again. Let's suppose the, okay, Harry, and the password is like 12345. Now let's click on the login try. Wrong username. Let's click on the sign up. But before sign up, let's try CEO. Click on sign up button. You can see real time is here, Harry and the password. Let's click on login now. You can see the main screen now. You will see an app main screen. Now we can see the login done. So this is the amazing app. Okay. So in the next video, we can learn like anyone can replace our password. Okay. If I just create any username, so anyone can replace my password. So how we can solve that problem? So for that, we need to check if that username exists or not. So in the next video, if you like that video, then I will create another video for that advanced version. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.